Host of Internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to use limit clause with bulk collect in Oracle database. So without wasting much of your time, let's start the tutorial. Now we have already learned the process of compressing multiple switches by using bulk collect with select into, and in turn get greater control over the query by using the same with fetch into statement of an explicit cursor. But the question remains that is there still scope for further query optimization? So my dear friends, in today's tutorial we will learn how we can further improve the performance of our query using the limit clause with bulk collect in Oracle database. You must be thinking, haven't we learned enough about query performance using bulk collect in the previous tutorials? Yes, you are right, but I won't say we have learned enough. There is still a bottleneck which requires our attention, that is the memory overhead caused by the bulk collect. So what is this memory overhead? Whenever we retrieve or fetch a large number of records using bulk collect clause, our program starts consuming a lot of memory in order to be fast and efficient. That degrades the performance of the database. This means that our query must surely be performing well, but at the same time our database may not. We cannot have a well-optimized query by compromising the performance of our entire database. So, how can we overcome this problem? This problem of memory exhaustion can easily be overcome if we can control and constrain the amount of data fetched using the bulk collect. We can do that by using bulk collect with limit clause. Let's move ahead and learn how to use bulk collect with limit clause in Oracle database. Server output is acting funny today. Let me check the spelling. SERVEROUTPUT. It's correct. Maybe it doesn't like the blue color. Anyways, so here is our declaration section, which is quite similar to the one we coded in the last tutorial. Once again, in our declaration section, we have two database objects. First is a cursor with name exp_cur, using which we are retrieving all the records from the first name column of employees table. And second object is the collection, which is nested table with the name nt_fname and its collection variable fname. This collection will be used for holding the data fetched using the specified cursor. Now let's move ahead and write the execution section. Here we have started our execution section, and in its beginning we have two executable statements. Since we are aware of the fact that in order to use the cursor we have to open it first, hence our first executable statement here is an open statement, using which we are opening our cursor. Followed by that we have our fetch statement. Except for the limit keyword, the entire statement is same as the one we saw in the last tutorial. The working of this statement is also pretty much the same. It's fetching the data from the cursor exp_cur and storing it into the collection nt_fname using its collection variable fname. But this time we have added an extra attribute to this statement, which is limit. Limit clause restricts the number of rows fetched using bulk collect with fetch statement. Always remember, the limit clause can only be used when you are using bulk collect with fetch into statement. It cannot be used when you are using bulk collect with select into statement. In order to use this statement, you first have to write the keyword limit followed by a number. This number specifies the number of rows that the bulk collect clause will retrieve in one go. In our example, we are retrieving 10 rows using limit clause. That's how we use limit clause with bulk collect. Seems like we are done with our cursor. Thus, we must close it. It is always advisable to close the cursor and relinquish the resources when you are done with it. Though this PLSQL block is complete, but we can still write a loop to display back all the 10 rows we fetched using the limit clause with bulk collect. Let's do that also. Here is our loop. It will print the index number followed by the first name which we have fetched and stored into our collection. Now we are all set to execute our program and see the result. But before executing it, a quick reminder for you to hit the thumbs up button and like this video. Your every single like keeps me motivated for creating more such interesting content. Also, if you are new to this channel, then go ahead and subscribe as more such interesting videos are coming your way. That being said, let's go ahead and execute our program. And here is our result. 10 rows fetched and displayed back to the user. But there is another little problem with limit clause. If you execute this same program again, then this fetch into statement with limit clause will not append the collection with the next 10 records. Rather, it will truncate the table and populate the nested table again from the index number 1. You can go ahead and read my blog to see how we can overcome this problem. So this time, instead of fetching all the records and exhausting an expensive resource like memory, thanks to the limit clause, we are retrieving only the necessary rows and that too without any resource wastage. This way, we can take our query performance a notch higher with bulk collect. You can read more about limit clause on my website. I will leave the link in the description. Do make sure to like, share and subscribe. This is the PLSQL tutorial on limit clause with bulk collect in Oracle database. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.